tell us a bit about your character, where he fits into the world of Alice through the Looking Glass.
Harcourt, who he works for Hamish, played by the wonderful Leo Bill, and he's an office clerk. You know, he's not. I don't want to say he's boring because he's not boring, but he's in his place at the moment, and he's gonna have to go through life like chipping away in order to get anywhere. And then suddenly this really flamboyant, strong-willed lady turns up, young woman who's kind of opens his eyes. And it's not that he's sort of raptured or in love with her. It's just that she is so strong and open, you know, and strong-willed that's something different for him, I think. It's fun. I mean, the thing is, a lot of what I shot was all on location and what I would call the real world. But still, it was mental because there's like 300 extras there, and you know, in this massive ballroom, and everyone's like dressed up to the nines. It's a lot of fun. I mean, you know, I'm lucky to do this for a living in any capacity, so getting wheeled out to do something like this was a lot of fun.
And tell me about working with such an incredible cast like it is for Alice through the Looking Glass.
Yeah, I mean, there's some really good people in there, and a lot of them I didn't get to. I mean, there's some really cool. He's really cool, and I didn't even get to work with him. I'm more sort of awestruck by him than like all the others. Like he's. Wicked, sorry. He's bleeping wicked. Old Andrew Scott, wow. He's a legend. And that is one of the folks. I don't do that when I'm on set. I take it very professionally, very seriously. But that's a great thing. I've wanted to do this since I was like 10 years old. So when you get a chance to go on set and work with some of these people, you've got to not take yourself so seriously. Get on with the job in hand and be focused. But and enjoy it, like, because I don't know how long it will go on for, you know. Getting a chance to work with certain people and getting to step into a world that I hadn't done before, and also, you know, getting to work with Mia was a wicked thing, and James as well. So,
and what do you think about sequels in general? It's quite a bold step to do it.
Yeah, I mean, I think that, you know, if the story's strong enough and the script's strong enough and the people involved are good enough, then why not? I mean, they do. Sequels go on. I mean, it's a big thing now, isn't it? It's like, let's do so-and-so number 17. But I think that, you know, if you get the story right, there's no reason why it can't work every, you know, ad infinitum, you know?